Hello everybody, welcome back to Chronicles of the Dark Lord, Episode 2, War of the Abyss. Okay, so I figure 1725, that's probably about it.
Beat that one last guy and try to time my attacks better when I'm beating down the flagship.
The hell? Oh, I went one file down. Good lord. Okay. Too bad she doesn't spread her attacks out if the enemy dies. Heals nearly 1,000. Oh god! Well, at least all I'm doing is wasting time. And yeah, that wasn't really a smart idea. That might even get me killed later, but wasn't. Necessarily gonna. Completely kill it if I can find some way to salvage this. Now I gotta remember to not hit the button.
like that. Because just hitting it... What I usually do when there's, like, a bunch of enemies out there is I just... Especially when I've got the attack selected, I just hit it 3 times. A little mess up with the heads up display, but how frequently they can fire that. Apparently fairly frequently. To last for 2 more hits. I've got 2 more energy cannons left, Inferni Blasts left. Damn it. Yeah, that. Those hits towards the beginning were probably what did me in. Do an average of about 900 damage, which I should be able to recover with the healing, and then I'll start taking them out one by one and wind up with more health in the end than I did before. Thank you. Or at least about the same. Right here, that wouldn't have been worth it to try to tank that damage. So just hit him with the Inferni Blast. But now I'm definitely gonna need to use that. That way I don't come out completely destroyed. You see, right there I came out in a little better shape than I did before. Right now, damage control, because I gotta tank the damage from the big ship. The little ones aren't much, but they'll add up. But I will be able to recover from their hits fairly quickly. As for them, I just hit those with the energy cannon in two shots and they're done. Two turns. Three turns. Four turns. One turn. Two turns. Three turns. Four turns. That's just what I needed. One turn. Two turns. And that's all I needed to win the battle. Looks like we routed them, boys. Well done. Let's go pick up the Emperor and his party. The chrysalis suffered no damage, Captain.
Good, good. We'll be setting down soon enough to pick up the Emperor and his party.
The crystal!
Oh no, Captain. The crystal is no longer fused with the diadem. Someone took it.
Search the ship. Make sure there's no damage to the crystal.
Aye, Captain.
My lord, here's the Inferni diadem.
Finally.
Well done, Ariadne. It appears though your method of torturing her inner essence into extinction has worked out in your favor, my lord.
Do I detect a hint of doubt that my plan worked to perfection, General?
No, my lord, of course not.
I knew they would have to land in Iliar in order to combat our troops there. Sending Ariadne on board while using her invisibility and then waiting for the right moment. It was a plan of pure genius. I owe a debt of gratitude to the Dark Lord for being so predictable. If I may say, my lord, you did take a chance that defusing the diadem and that flight crystal did not wipe out everything, including the diadem itself.
You dare question my judgment?
No, of course not, my lord. I was only meditating on how impressive your mind truly is when it comes to risk and strategy.
Enough of your blather. It's time for me to lay claim to their world.
Ariadne, I request your presence while Lord Anto conducts the infusion.
Yes, General.
It's time for the final infusion.
Shh, lower your voice. What can I do for you, General?
I know your inner self is not yet extinguished, and I have need of it. Chanin.
Diversi!
Splenor.
Urrak!
Come forth, Ariadne of Shinandara.
Infuse with the Inferni Diadem!
How? Why?
Finally. The world will soon be remade in my image.
There's no honor or glory to be had in a dead world. When we meet again, we'll be enemies. Until then, Ariadne. You saw nothing, heard nothing. That is an order, understand? Yes, General.
Avaros!
Yes, my lord? The Dark Lord and his comrades will no doubt mount a counter-offensive on our Nexus Towers soon. I want you to head for Ingersoll. Ariadne, you will go to Avis. Destroy any who seek to enter into either tower.
Of course, my lord.
Yes, my lord. In the meantime, I'm going to establish a tower of my own in Senefarius lands. From there, I will obliterate everything that lives. Ah, my ultimate vengeance is at hand.
Here is what we know. An Abyssal snuck on board when they landed near Ilion. They managed to fuse the diadem from the flight crystal, and now we can assume that Anto is about to invade our world with his physical presence. I do not know what will happen when he does, but I do know that we cannot waste any time. We need to attack the two Nexus Towers and destroy them. That will cause the Abyss to lose their foothold in our world. At that point, we'll be able to take the fight directly to Anto. Your thoughts?
The elemental mistresses have promised that when we attack one of the towers, they will be the diversion so that we can get in there. They will not be able to pull it off a second time. And then we need to worry about the second tower later on. Whichever tower we pick first is the one we focus on destroying. I agree with Drea. We'll deal with the problem of the second tower when we've dealt with the first. Yeah, I say we get in there and kick some serious abyssal ass. As long as we don't run into any giant flying roaches or mosquitoes, I'm fine. I echo my counterpart sentiment, especially near the flying roaches part. I think we're all in agreement, Magus. Is no one going to mention trying to rescue Jelena?
No.
Father? Magus, she's your wife.
I know who she is, Megara. I cannot risk everything for one person, even if that person is my wife. Destroying Anto and his forces is paramount above all else, no matter the personal cost. Oh, no.
It's him. He's in our world now.
Shit!
We know what we must do. Once we are fully prepared, we will head for Rakaltra to pick up the elemental mistresses, and we will head for one of the Nexus Towers.
Oh, good.
Oh, real quick, gotta heal up. See what all skills he's got access to. Not many. What about them? They're not on the Scion grid. What about Megara? Might as well, we're gonna need another healer sometime later on. Yes, I do. That might come in handy later on. Thank you. upgrade the neglected characters a bit. Because the way this game goes, I figure they're all probably gonna need to be upgraded to a certain extent. Given the amount of times we've had to split up. Check out real quick, see how many of these we've got. Okay, so we've got 12.
Find some more attribute scions.
Most of what he's got is skills, so he can't really
upgrade him beyond just boosting his weapon up to level 5. Thank you.
amazing how I'm just defaulting back to the party that I used to finish off Xeon in
Tides of Fate.
That's the only new place on the map, or at least on the selection screen.
Be really nice if they, just won't let you explore, but
it's also good that they don't make you explore either, because, seriously, this world is huge.
There's some sort of force field blocking the way. We need to destroy the Nexus Towers first if we have any chance of getting Anto.
Shouldn't be playing this peaceful music. Jesus Christ, what was that?
This place has been utterly destroyed.
Oh, right, I need to go. I remember where I need to go now. Wait a minute, what?
I don't think that Infernus is supposed to look that green, but okay.
Perhaps later we shall explore this area more.
Okay,
I guess I forgot what this place was. What the hell?
Oh, it's just a fort. You must be Major Dragon Lee.
Indeed. Your name?
The name's Jareth. I was hoping to run into you someday, Dire Lord.
Why is that?
Don't worry, I'm not in league with the enemy or anything. I suppose you could call me an observer of yours.
I see.
Just remember one thing, Magus. Sometimes fate can be a cruel mistress. Throughout all my travels, haven't seen what I've seen.
I'll not pretend to know what your life has been like, Jareth. However, your experiences do not mirror my own. Therefore, your words carry little weight.
Actually, Dark Lord, I used to share many similarities with you, but that was in a different place, in a different time in my life.
Who are you? And I do not mean your name.
I told you before, I'm an observer of yours, Dark Lord. Some other vested interest in your fate, whatever that may be.
Why?
Oh, that's an answer for another time, I think. Until we meet again, Dagnalord.
Okay, then.
Oh, yeah. Wait, what?
Okay.
welcome to the arena. My name's Darian. If you want to participate, then I'm your man. First things first, you'll need to know the rules. First thing you need to know is battles are one-on-one. Friends and families and participants will have to observe just like everybody else. Once you enter the interval battle, you'll have the freedom to move however you like. Here are the basics. Up, left, up, jump, left, right, left, move, left, right.
Okay, so it's a fighting game.
Also, every time you attack, you'll use up some of your stamina. This will recover very quickly, but if you don't keep an eye on it, could mean your downfall. In addition, your current experience level and equipment and physical stats can play a significant factor in deciding the outcome of each battle. Lastly, a participant was only awarded victory when they have knocked out their opponent, as their opponents have ranged from Janari to battle-hardened warriors from all over the world. If you need any of that repeated, just let me know and I'll give it go over all with you again before you start a match. So, which one of you has the tenacity to enter the arena?
I do. My name's Zeria Lee, and I've been aching for combat like this for a long time. Finally, a chance to really test my mettle.
May victory be yours, Zeria. We'll be watching you.
Very well. Speak to you again when you are ready, Lady Zeria.
What are you buying, stranger?
No, please. 200 staring is nothing. I hate fighting games with joysticks. Jesus Christ, you guys put a... You guys put a fighting game in this.
This is extremely floaty. Not just in part because the controls are so bad. Rather because I'm using a joystick. Barely lost that. Gonna reload that because seriously, screw having to go through that again. Oh, sweet combo. Scorponox. I'm fighting a Decepticon, apparently. Like the characters are flying. In fact, it would actually make more sense if this was like a Dragon Ball fighting game. Really, all I'm doing is just moving left and right and smacking X whenever the enemy gets near. Occasionally timing it a little differently. So a slime beat enough people that it was able to get to number 10 on the rankings. Interesting. What was he fighting?
barely getting any real hits here. Mostly I'm just getting in recoil damage. Yeah, I don't think this is very good. I mean, it's a little too imprecise, I think. Actually, let me try it with the D-pad. The keyboard. Let's see if that works. Circle. Oh, come on! Beat the last opponent just by smacking the keyboard. Not the keyboard. The X button. And moving left and right. I thought that was like a glitch at first. That certainly is a glitch. At least the water's back to normal now. It's weird how some RPGs like this. I mean, I know that. You remember Final Fantasy VII had that bike minigame in it, and then. It's like. 8 had a card game in the middle of it.
Just straight the hell out of nowhere.
I mean, yeah, that's what we come to an RPG for: fighting games, card games.
Although the bike racing in Final Fantasy VII was actually pretty cool.
Oh. Didn't mean to bump the microphone like that. I suppose we are. Mother, you should remain here where it is relatively safe.
Not happening, Mages. This is one mission I need to be there for. Nothing you can say will dissuade me from this.
Very well.
We'll see you on board.
Might as well go to the Nexus Tower.
Hmm.
We have hostiles heading our way.
Stay on course, Captain. We're going to need you four to unleash your combined powers quite soon.
Understood, Magus. You heard the man. Get ready.
I'm ready, Scintilla.
Prepared.
I'm ready to kick some abyssal ass.
Magus, we're ready. Waiting on your word.
Wait.
We can see them. They're closing in on us.
Stand by. Hold your fire until you see the whites of their eyes.
Magus!
At my command. Now!
By your powers combined.
By your powers combined, I am Captain Planet!
By our powers combined, we unleash the might of the elements. Spirit Blast! We did it. Good job, sisters. Done what we could. The rest is up to you.
Captain, land on the summit of the tower. Be ready to take off at a moment's notice when we return.
Aye, Emperor. Now come alive! Now come back alive, you hear? Just like old times.
Hi.
Hey, they set up the music so that it continues instead of just restarting. Awesome. Let's see how well they handle a piercing gale.
Not very well.
As well test it out here.
See what all's effective and what ain't.
Feeling one's probably a red herring and the other's the right one. Well, they could both lead to the same place, so I'm gonna save and then come back to it.
If one is wrong, I'll just reload that save.
Thank you.
sounds slightly remixed from the version in Tides of Fate. Either that or a bit distorted. So Plague Barrage hits everybody, and even the small enemies have it now, huh? Interesting. It's a remix. Because this part wasn't in the original. Trying to loot the treasure for right now. Oh, wonderful. That did a whole lot of damage, yeah. Maybe if I was level 1... Oh, come on. Whole square away from that guy. Trying to find a healing crystal here. Thank you.
Wonderful. Should have saved it some point in there, but I guess I'll see you later with more.